Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Between Bangwa, Bakwere, and Bayangi men, which one make the best husband? Ah, first of all, with all humility, because I pride myself in being very humble, I want to say thank you for asking me that question. Between Bangwa, Bakwere, and Bayangi men, which ones make the best husband? First of all, let me start with the Bangwa men. Yes, because it's good to start where sense begins. See, Bangwa men are very, very handsome people. Yes. If it is handsomeness you're looking for, they are very handsome. That one is no prayer point. But the only thing is that, you know, they say that Bangwa men are 99 cents. These people are so intelligent, they even think they can edit the mind of God. See, Bangwa men, people say they are very stingy. But I like to think that is because they don't like spending. Yeah, Bangwa men do not have a very good relationship with spending. They study management. They came into the world having a PhD in financial management. As a matter of fact, spending is not one of their talents. They are not talented in spending. Yes, they are not stingy. They don't just enjoy spending. And one very amazing thing about Bangwa men is their sense of dressing. Yes, you know, their sense of dressing, I think, is hanging under a tree in the Garden of Eden. I think they have exchanged their sense of dressing with their sense of money. Yes. So, but they are very good men. I have a few Bangwa men that are very good. They are very awesome. Like Ahu Sing Song. The young man is trying, he's doing well. Now, we move to the Bakwere man. Bakwere. As a matter of fact, the Bakwere man is the most romantic man in Cameroon. They are the Romeos of our time. The way he loves a woman. My brother, if it is your woman that the Bakwere man falls in love with, they will definitely leave you. Because they are so sweet. Even their language. Their language is so romantic. Espanol or French, not rich. Yes. If a Bakwere man takes care of a woman, you will even insult your father in the house. You know that God does not love you. There's a way these guys love. You will see the totality of God's love. But the challenge with their relationship is that it does not last longer than a WhatsApp status.
Hey!
Are you understanding it?
Yes.
It's important you understand. See, Bakwere men are very romantic. They are the baby I'm here for you. They are the Romeos of Cameroon. Very sweet. But you see, one thing about them is that they might be dating you seriously. Why serious is dating another person? Their relationship reminds me of the scripture that says that where two or three are gathered, the Lord is in their midst. Because it is hardly you alone. It's going to be two or three. Because the Lord needs to be there to ensure that heads don't roll. They are very political. That is why a lot of people say that they are lazy. But I think they are just passively participatory. But they are very good people. Very kind people. And they can spend too. Yes. Just that their relationship don't last longer than WhatsApp status. Yeah, we move to the Bayangi people. Bayangi boys. The pride of the nation. Yes, these are the pride of the nation. Yes, in fact, all of them, they pride themselves in being very humble. See, Bayangi guys are very neat, very intelligent, and they know how to give. They are visionaries. They always know what they are doing. At a very young age, they already know what they want to become, and they are very good at what they do. They know how to spend. They are naturally born givers. A Bayangi man is a giver. They are the ones that can go to a party and shut it down like they do farotage and check and go home. They don't mind. They know how to support their own. They give a woman space to be whoever she wants to be. They are not intimidated by the greatness of their woman. You understand? Some people say that Bayangi boys or Bayangi men are cheats. I don't agree. I just think that the demand for Bayangi boys is more than the supply. So a few Bayangi boys that are still Gentiles are working extra hard to meet up with the increasing demand. Yes, but generally they are very awesome people. They are dedicated to excellence. They don't like mediocrity. See, if they want to be music artists, they will not be anything less than Stanley Enoch King Kong. They will not be anything less than Tizi Pacha or Salatier. If they want to play football, they will not be anything less than Eno Young. If they want to be hotel or be billionaires, they will not be anything less than Da Costa Watson. If they want to be gospel rappers, they will not be anything less than G4. Are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
So they are excellent in all their ways. The only challenge could be that they will never be wrong. Yes, because they always know what they are doing. It would be very difficult for a Bayangi man to admit that they are wrong. Only very few of them. Few of us who pride ourselves in being humble.
So, which of these men will you advise your sister to marry?
First of all, with all humility, I want to state that whoever my sister marries, I don't have much to say about it because that is her pot of soup. You understand? But if I must advise her to give her wisdom, I would tell her to marry a Bayangi man. That has a just small touch of financial management, like a Bangwa man. That is as romantic as a Bakwere man. But above all, I want my sister to marry a man that is in the presence of God, that can nourish her in the way of the Lord and show her in the path of righteousness. Because any Bangwa man, Bakwere man, or Bayangi man, that is not a Christ man, is a Babylon.
Let them lecture for something. The Baptist.